have the virginity prayer by the students of class 4.
As long as there is life, there is hope. The good in humanity will always strive to counter the evil. So let us all join and invoke the Almighty for help. Lord, give us love, give us peace on earth, give us light, give us hope. Help us to cope with this heavy goal of trying to achieve peace and harmony in the world. I am the world's citizen. I pray for the happiness of all the countries of the world. May peace prevail on earth.
Will not be peaceful until we ourselves are at peace within. May unity prevail on earth. May unity prevail in all the countries of Asia. May unity be in Asia.
A daily, a weekly, a monthly process, gradually changing opinions, slowly enrolling old barriers, quietly building new structures. May unity prevail on earth. May unity prevail in all the countries of Africa. May unity be in Africa.
Overcomes the love of power, the world will know peace. May unity prevail on earth. May unity prevail in all the countries of Oceania. May unity be in Oceania.
I'm Chandrashish Kukreti, and I will be speaking on the topic how the internet will help us, the Commonwealth nations, to connect better. The internet is only a few decades old, and in that short span of time, it has shown significant changes. It grew out of a hodgepodge of many independent networks into now a global entity. We can connect to this enormous network via dozens of different devices. The internet now serves as a base for business, for communication, for entertainment, for education, for whatnot. So what's next? Where else can we go? When one can call up a minute trivia about the most irrelevant subject one can think of, with just a couple of taps on a smartphone screen. Where else do we need to go? The answer isn't entirely clear, but the possibilities are exciting. One thing that is absolutely certain is that global data transmission speeds will increase gradually. According to Akamai Technologies, which produces a quarterly global state of the internet report, The average global data transmission speed in late 2009 was about 1.7 megabits per second. Now compare that to what has been achieved by Bell Labs, 100 petabits per second. Now that is an enormous gap between what is commercially available and what is possible. However, in the near future, almost one thing is certain, that the cost for producing and maintaining such high-speed internet networks will decrease. But how will that help us? How will that help us, the Commonwealth nations, to connect better? The answer is simple, yet it is intriguing. Better internet connectivity would mean that the Commonwealth nations are now closer than ever before. Video conferencing would be much better, and so would be the trade. Internet is becoming the backbone of nearly all the business transactions that are taking place. And it is certain that in the near future, the internet will be the only method of transactions taking place. This means the international trade would flourish, as currency would not be a problem anymore. Not only trade, but the medical facilities would improve too. As a better connected network, we would now be able to maintain a more accurate and highly detailed record of all the organ donor, the surgical instruments, the prosthetics, and whatnot. And not only that, we will be able to share that data with all the countries around the world. Imagine how helpful that would be for the people.
I am Manasvi Pathak, and I'm here to present my views on the topic, Family, Society, Nation, Commonwealth. What are the opportunities for shared sustainable growth? Commonwealth is one of the most diverse and dynamic intergovernmental networks. It's a society of global trade, migration, ideas, and yes, with the risk of pandemic diseases, refugee movements, terrorism, and conflicts. Economic growth is the foundation of all material prosperity. In our age, quantitative growth is not enough. It has to be sustainable. By sustainable growth, we mean a rate of output which meets the needs of the present generation without compromising on the abilities of the future generation to meet their own needs.
I, Devashish Pandey, am going to speak on the topic, Commonwealth connects the nations across the borders and what we can learn from our neighbors. The Commonwealth of Nations, better known as the Commonwealth, is a unique political association of 53 member countries, nearly all of them territories of the British Empire, which is now home to almost 2.4 billion people. In an era of changing economic circumstances, new trade and economic patterns, unprecedented threats to peace and security led to the formation of the Commonwealth. The member states are united by English language, history, culture, and their shared values of democracy, gender equality, human rights, protection of the environment, role of civil society, and the rule of law.
I, Angira Singh Bhatt, am here to talk about the significance of the Commonwealth in maintenance of a sustainable environment. The Commonwealth of Nations dates back to the first half of the 20th century with the decolonization of the British Empire. Its formal constitution was by the London Declaration in 1949, declaring all its member states as free and equal. For the annual celebration of the Commonwealth, this year, the theme is a connected Commonwealth. Such a Commonwealth aims to help us protect our environment and the oceans that we share. It cooperates on trade and encourages economic growth. It speaks of the enduring practical value and global engagement made possible as a result of the determination of our culturally diverse and widely dispersed family of nations.
Now, I would like to invite our chief guest, Mrs. Padmaja Chauhan, IPS, Inspector General of Police, Uttar Pradesh Police Recruitment Board, to bless the students.
I'm deeply honored and delighted to be here with all of you on the Commonwealth Day celebration. And thank you for all the kind words you've said about me. I will take this opportunity to talk about one of the most common problems faced by us in the modern day world, namely the increasing stress levels, especially among the youth. This is a natural result of the increasing competition and also the increasing amount of information that we are exposed to. So, how do you manage this stress? I learned one important thing about managing stress when we were imparting training to our commandos in one of the battalions headed by me. We train our commandos to function effectively in highly stressful and life-threatening situations. In the commando training module, we have what we call the one-minute drills. We train our men to do certain important tasks in a time span of 60 seconds or 1 minute. One of these drills is changing into the combat gear with your helmets, boots, and bulletproof vests on, and then to take position with your weapons ready for the combat in a period of 60 seconds. Then we have a 1 minute drill in which you dismantle the rifle, clean it, remove all the blockages, and put it all back together again in 60 seconds time. Each of these tasks would have taken not less than 15 minutes for someone who has not learned these drills. Then we started creating drills for many more complex tasks. By doing this, we found a remarkable improvement in their ability to overcome stress and to carry out difficult operations. So the key to overcome stress is effective time management. For a student, time management might mean dividing your time between your studies, sports, friends, and the internet. For a working professional like me, it means achieving the right work-life balance. How is this done? All of us have long-term goals that we want to achieve, but we do not set daily goals that lead us to these long-term goals. The first important thing in time management is setting daily goals. Ask yourself every morning, what are all the things you want to complete today? Once you have decided what your goals are, define these goals as clearly as possible. If you are a student, instead of saying, I will study for 4 hours today, say that I will complete the second chapter of physics in 2 hours' time and the fourth lesson of English in the next 2 hours today evening. Try to be as specific as possible in defining your goals. When you do this, you will discover that you are accomplishing much more than what you have been doing all along. So the three important steps for time management would be, one, set daily goals which agree with your long-term goals. Second, define these goals as clearly as possible. And third, define the time frame in which you want to complete your daily task. Coming to the theme of time, theme of this year's Commonwealth Day, it is the responsibility of each one of us to save our environment and to empower people. We can do this by living a life without causing any distress to other people and also to the planet. Each of us can be the change and make an impact on the world. I must say I'm very inspired with the speeches of the students today, and they have filled my heart with hope. Before I conclude my speech, I would like to congratulate Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, Professor Geeta Gandhi, and their team for building up this wonderful institution, namely the City Montessori School. You are doing amazing work in the field of education and in promoting the message of One World. And my special thanks to Mrs. Abha Anand, the principal of this campus, for inviting me here. Thank you.
Dalai Lama once said, and I quote, "Whether we like it or not, we all have been born into this world as a part of one great human family. Rich or poor, educated or uneducated, belonging to one nation or another, adhering to this ideology or that. Ultimately, each one of us is just a human being, like everyone else. We all desire happiness and do not want suffering." Unquote. This year, we celebrate Commonwealth Day at City Montessori School with the theme, A Connected Commonwealth, which recognizes the value of joy and belonging to this great family. Here come the citizens of South America who represent peace and humility. children dressed up beautifully, representing North America, who spread the message of love and justice. Continent of Europe, symbolizing unity and trust.
With fingers on the pulse of modernity, with eyes on the limitless possibilities of success, and yet with feet on the ground, and with feet firmly on the ground of realities and complexities, Mr. Roshan Gandhi, an alumni of Oxford University, is our director of strategy. I invite him to say a few words.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to be here, and pleasure to be enjoying this very joyous performance just now. We're especially grateful to respected Mrs. Chauhan for being amongst us, and I was very much interested in everything she said in her talk just now. Very, very relevant to all of you, I think. You know, it's exam time and all of that, so it's perhaps a stressful period. But however much stress you think you're going through, the respected lady here is dealing with police force and training them, and that is a level of stress which none of us can imagine. And so she has true insight in how one has to go about dealing with stress, dealing with time management, dealing with planning, dealing with goal setting. And so I hope you've all taken heed and taken good note of that. I originate from the country which is the head of the Commonwealth. It was a proud emotional moment for me to be able to garland the Queen this morning. And I'm very fortunate, very glad that the world has the good fortune of living in a situation where there is no longer an imperial empire building approach, but rather those same principles of coordination across large spaces of geography are happening with the thought of peace, with the thought of collaboration, cooperation, trade, and generally working towards bringing greater joy and happiness amongst the people. So that is really what the Commonwealth is all about. That is what we're celebrating here today. And I won't keep you for long. Please do enjoy the remainder of the celebrations. Thank you very much.
I now invite Batra ma'am to bless us with a few words.
This function brings back old memories. As I walked into this auditorium, I remembered for so many years we were celebrating, and it was not easy to celebrate because it was in between the examination. But then the children performed very well, and they used to look forward for this function, Commonwealth, and a very appropriate theme, a connected Commonwealth. So children, I must compliment you, the children who spoke today. I'm sure you didn't have much time to prepare for these speeches, but the speeches were wonderful, you spoke very well, and these little babies who performed on the stages now, they really won our heart. How beautifully, and they were thoroughly enjoying themselves on the stage. So I must compliment the principal, Mrs. Abhava Anand, for organizing this function. I know it's not easy during the examination when you can't even take the practices and you literally have to force the children to stay back after school. So I must congratulate you and thank you very much. It was a pleasure attending this function. Thank you very much.